Good morning, my dear students. Today we are going to see Act 2, Scene 9. In this scene, we will see that at Belmont, the second suitor to Portia, the Prince of Aragon, makes his choice of the casket. The last scene which took place in Belmont was Prince of Morocco's choosing of casket. This scene is also taking place in Belmont, and here comes the Prince of Aragon to make his choice of the casket. Vain and self-conceited, he feels that he deserves Portia more than anyone else. He chooses a silver casket which says, "Who chooses me shall get as much as he deserves." The casket has the portrait of Blinking Idiot rather than that of Portia. So he has to depart quickly. Portia learned the arrival of a Venetian suitor. Nerissa prays that he should be Bassanio, whom Portia likes secretly. So these all are the things that is taking place in Act 2, Scene 9. And this is the last scene of Act 2. For our syllabus, we want to learn one more scene, Act 3, Scene 1. With that, our syllabus will be over and we will start our revision. In this scene, we are going to learn more about the silver casket. And also, at the end, we will learn that our Portia is secretly liking Bassanio. Bassanio once visited Belmont. Nerissa, the servant and close friend of Portia, is reminding about the beauty of Bassanio. So, by the scenes that is taking place in Belmont, we came to know about the casket system, about three caskets, the descriptions on it, the rules that a suitor must keep when he comes to choose the casket. We learn from the Morocco's scene what is there inside the golden casket. And by this scene, we will know about what is there inside the silver casket. The Prince of Aragon is one of the leading suitors of Portia. He returns after taking his oath and is ready to choose one of the caskets. Portia shows him the caskets and tells him that if you choose the right casket, that is, the casket which contains her portrait, she will marry him at once and become his wife. But if he chooses the wrong casket, he will have to leave the place at once without uttering a word. The prince tells Portia that he has taken the oath to observe three things if he failed to choose the right casket. Namely, not to tell anyone which casket he had chosen, not to marry any other woman, and not to stay for a moment at this place. Portia tells him that every suitor has to observe these three things. So here, in this scene, the rules to choose the casket is being discussed. We already learned about these three rules. The Prince of Aragon is specifying the three rules to choose the casket. And Portia tells that every suitor must obey these rules. After this, we will see that the Prince of Aragon is approaching the caskets and judging. The Prince of Aragon approaches the leaden casket, but rejects it at once. He then examines the inscriptions on the golden casket. He thinks that what many men desire to possess may not be desired by him, because he does not want to rank himself with the common people. He then turns to the silver casket and read the inscriptions which says, "Who chooses me shall get as much as he deserves." This inscription appeals to him because he thinks that he deserves the hand of Portia in marriage. He then selects the silver casket. When he opens it, he finds in it the portrait of a blinking idiot presenting a skull in which it is written that those who do not think carefully before taking any step in any matters are fooled in life. In the same way, the Prince of Aragon has been fooled. He then thinks that it was foolish on his part to have come to Belmont and try his luck by the caskets. Then he made a fool of himself by choosing a wrong casket. So he at once leaves the place. The thoughts that Prince of Aragon is using to choose the silver casket is important here.
You want to critically analyze the judgment of a Prince of Aragon and a Prince of Morocco. There can be questions to compare the judgment of a Prince of Aragon and a Prince of Morocco. What all are the thoughts that they deal with? Prince of Morocco was continuously thinking about his high birth and royal blood. In this scene, Prince of Aragon's thoughts are attached with the inscriptions on silver casket. Who chooses me shall get as much as he deserves. He justified that description by thinking that he deserved the hand of Portia in marriage. He then moralizes over the corruption in the world. He says that the most undeserving people occupy high positions, whereas the most deserving people act as their subordinates. He then selected the silver casket. So here, his explanation to choose the silver casket is different. So we must critically analyze the thoughts of Prince of Aragon with the comparison of Prince of Morocco. After Prince of Morocco leave that place, Portia remarks that he has been burned in the flames like a moth, and that she is glad that he has chosen the wrong casket. There, Naresa remarks that death and marriage depends on destiny. At that moment, a servant arrives to inform that there is a messenger. He has come with greetings and presents. Portia tells Naresa that she is eager to meet the suitor because he appears to possess decent manners. Naresa wishes that this suitor may turn out to be Lord Bassanio. There we will come to know about the secret liking of Portia towards Lord Bassanio. Once Bassanio visited Belmont, and Naresa and Portia remember about that person. That is the reason why Naresa wishes that this suitor may turn out to be Lord Bassanio. The servant arrived to inform that there is a messenger who came with greetings and presents from Venice. There, Naresa wishes that this suitor must be Lord Bassanio. Dear students, read and understand the textbook properly. Try to find out the answers for your workbook exercises. Thank you.